This channel is about hip-hop. Nothing but hip-hop. This channel was designed to attract and locate hip-hop heads of the highest regard from all over the world. This channel grows slow because finding the right people takes time. If you are watching this live video right now, it means you bleed and breathe hip-hop. We're glad you're here. You are why this channel exists. Now let's get the party started. Enjoy the show.
Growing up, things were tough, no problem. I got a great family, we're not talking about knee scuffing, powderized bones, alone in my poetry. There's no thoughts have been blessed me ever since I've been a shorty. Almost drowned twice, I fell through the ice, I broke each leg and ripped twice. My jaw's been wired shut nice, couldn't even chew through food. Liquid diet, imbalancing my moods, wheelchair respect. 1 year and a half with no legs, my skull screwed into as I was pissing into a bag. I had a cognitive lag. Facial reconstruction, plastic surgery, heparin to stop blood clotting, gangrene infection, threatening amputation, morphine injections, mental projections of symmetry after death, limbo, won't God check the beat except, the devil cried out, he's almost mine, the game was too close, so they each took half my mind.
Okay, here we go, that was kind of rough, sorry, I'm trying something new with the music at the start. I figured, I was just sitting here waiting, and Ignacio was a little late, so I'm like fucking around, and there's actually a function on here, to add music to the podcast. So I was thinking of just like playing a song as people kind of come in. And right off the bat, we got fucking six people in here. So that's fucking dope. This nice. Is Temple of Bars 1.4. Everybody, 1.4. Toolerific is the champion. Nico is the runner-up. Toolerific so made this playlist.
Essentially what this is wrapping up volume one today, right?
Yeah. We start volume 2.1 next week. So I can't comment out of the live chat until this live is done. But as soon as this video is done, I already have the mixtape made. I got to add a couple tracks from Nico. But the mixtape and the playlist will be in the pinned comments. All the mixtapes are available at wilkshake.bandcamp.com. There is three mixtapes. This will be the fourth. Thank you, Nico. Thank you, Toolerific. Thank you for all the requests.
Absolutely.
So how it worked was Toolerific supported the show the hardest in the last 3 weeks.
Yep.
And Nico also supported the show very hard. It was kind of a fucking close race between those two.
It was.
Tool had 9 and Nico had 7.
Yeah, so that's averaging $15 to this show a week.
And it's much appreciated.
Shout out to the supporters, man.
Yes, dope. You're clean, Chuck. You're nice and clean cut. Got a haircut, trim the beard.
I did. It got to the point where I had to deal with it. And so That's usually when I get a haircut.
There you go.
I wait until I have to deal with it. So
I'm so fucking bald that I just have to get, I just buzz it. I'm like an Osseo. Like I just keep it. I'm so bald. I can't have haircuts.
Every 2-3 days, I just grab a razor and.
Oh, you razor it. I just like wait like 3 weeks. So I look like I'm 58.
And then, yeah,
then I should buzz it.
I started going gray like fairly early, but I kept it all. So
yeah,
I'll take it. I would rather have kept it in gray.
Yeah, totally, dude. Like look at this. I'm 40 years old. Not one gray whisker in my beard.
Oh, it's in there. Yeah. It's in there.
You know what's weird? I got a couple gray pubes.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
That's a thing.
So that's Fierce. I got gray pubes, dude. I got gray, just to let you know, I got gray pubes.
Yeah. And thank you, everybody.
Not all of them, just like a little patch.
We'll be leaving Kentucky in just a few minutes.
Right. Will we?
Nope. Dude, Kentucky is why people come, bro. That's why I show up.
I feel like we're just stepping on the Appalachian Trail here.
There we go.
Well, guys, we got a fantastic playlist. There's no surprises tonight. On the screen, you can see exactly what is coming up. Let's get into Run's House. This is Temple of Bars, guys. Thank you very much for being here. This is Run DMC.
Let's get it.
Run's House. And by the way, Toolerific said the first five songs are what got him into hip-hop, and the next five are some of his personal favorites.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Okay, Run DMC, Run's House. Let's do it. I don't know a lot of Run DMC, to be honest. Ooh, I like me some old school hip hop.
And it does Run DMC.
Right?
Who are the MCs in Run DMC?
We have DMC and Grandmaster J and Rev Run.
Rev Run. Daryl Mack is DMC. Toolerific's here.
Yeah,
this is all,
yeah,
this is all you. This is all you, Toolerific.
How are you, man?
If you want to get a playlist made on the show, go for 2.4. Dude, it's the yelling, dude. I like when dudes yell. I did that. That's just my thing.
The intensity?
Oh, yeah. I broadcasted my band's show to the wrong page.
I saw that.
Yeah.
I can't delete it.
Hey, I didn't hear any audio on that either. Oh.
I love the mixing work. I love the DJ work, dude. Like the scratching, that shit. And dude, I think I finally figured out what it is about old school, dude. Like, fucking old school dudes were fucking angrier. Times were tougher, I guess. But there's much more aggression in old school hip hop than there is in new school.
There was much more talk about struggle in hip hop.
Yeah, which I fucking love. Out.
And then, you know, before it turned into
beef,
money, cash, hoes.
Yeah. And then, and beef too.
You know, but, I mean, everybody who was making it big, even like late 80s, early 90s, they weren't really still making it big. Cause that's when the all the record labels were still pretty much screwing everybody over.
Yeah.
So, you know, it was still, hard times on a lot of them. So even though they were, you know, on the record cover, they looked like they had money and they had cars and all this and that. A lot of them didn't really have all that. You know, they were still
it was all owned by the label, and they'd,
they made jack shit. Fucking
made jack shit, unless they toured.
Dude, record labels are on the fucking way out. Dudes, they are going to be a thing of the past. 20 years.
There's going to be still some people though who don't know how to market themselves that are still going to there's somebody out there that's still going to need a label.
It's just so easy to do yourself.
I know, but some people aren't savvy enough yet.
Yeah, some people have no idea. Yeah, savvy. You know? That's the word.
But that was a good track.
That fired me up, dude. I was kind of tired. I golf. I do a lot of shit on Tuesday. I went fucking ocean kayaking this morning. I put away an order. I cleaned the fryers.
I know, man.
Yeah, so it's a long day, but that fired me up. So I'm in a good mood. I'm going to go ahead and give that an 8.3 because I love that energy.
Wow.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, I can ask the crowd.
All right. Let's see. We'll give it a 7.
7.
We'll give it a 7. Because it's not my favorite Run DMC song, but
right.
It's good.
I know very little, dude, and that was really
fun. Yeah, it's 7 for me. That was fun. It's an enjoyable track to listen to.
Yeah.
I think I got a soft spot for things before 95. You know, I do. It's like it's my shit. It's
you know they like make the best. They make cream for that.
They probably do. But I actually judge all new music on this era of hip hop, like because this is where I think it was the fucking best. I think it went downhill after this. It's like punk rock, when punk kind of evolved, and it's punk split into two paths, grunge and punk rock, and punk rock stayed in their lane, and then it just went downhill after the 90s. And I think it's the same kind of thing as hip hop, dude.
Okay, all right.
I think the early 90s is the golden era, dude. That's my favorite stuff to listen to.
Okay, all right. I mean, I was going to tell you. Go ahead. You're good.
I was going to say, I think the mid-aughts, like the 03 to 06, 07, that was kind of its own
Experiment.
There's a lot of good stuff from the early 2000s.
No, there is. Yeah, I'm not saying there's not, but there was there was a lot more sound experimentation being done with different bass lines and different melodies and, you know, different things like that were happening in that mid to late 2000s that started to turn the page on some of the hip hop that we were listening to.
I like Tularific's playlist too, because he's kind of giving us a spectrum and a story of his hip hop, you know, like
right.
So I'm suspecting he's a little older than us, like probably 45
or around the same age,
or I'd say a little older
he said his dad gave him $10 one day to and told him to run across the street to Kmart and get this Run DMC cassette.
That's how his love began.
That's awesome, dude.
That's tight.
If you refresh, Tracy Nicolini, what's up, Tracy?
If you refresh
I saw you wanted to look at your friend's song, but maybe next week you can request it. Anyway, this is a dedicated night for Nico and Tularific. What are you gonna say?
I'm gonna tell you if you refresh the page, I added Nico's songs to the playlist already, to the mixtape playlist already.
Oh, to the mixtape. I don't have the mixtape open, do I?
The one you have on right now. If you refresh it.
When you literally have open right now?
Yeah. If you refresh it, then his tracks will be at the bottom.
Nice. They sure are. Uh-huh. Oh, that makes life so easy. I got a real easy. There's going to be lots of Kentucky tonight, guys, because I got my job so easy tonight because I don't have to do anything. I don't have to do anything. Like, I just sit here and do – I got it as easy as you guys. I love week four. Oh, man. Week four is the best. He said I love it. Week four is the best. Point four. Oh, I'm gonna get point four tattooed on me somewhere. Point four is my jam. Run DMC runs house. These guys think 100% say yes. I think so too. Just out of respect, I think that needs to go in the playlist. Mm-hmm. And I think that's dope. So let's get into the next one.
Let's do it. Growing up, things were tough. No quacking. I got a great family. We're not talking about knee scuffing, powderized bones, alone in my poetry. There's no thoughts have been blessed me ever since I've been a
Johnny.
Almost drowned twice. I fell through the ice. I broke each leg and ripped twice. My jaw's been wired shut nice. Couldn't even chew through food. Liquid diet and balancing my moods. Wheelchair respect. 1 year and a half with no legs. My skull screwed into as I was pissing into a bag. I had a cognitive lag. Facial reconstruction.
All right, that's not working for me. What's up, everybody? We are here. It is Temple of Brothers. Did you guys hear that? Did you hear it?
Yeah.
I can't hear it sometimes. It just does nothing. Anyway, guys, I'm glad we're here. This is the playlist of Tula Rip, everybody.